Since the 12th century, the farmers of Brittany near the mouth of the River Rance have brought their grain to mills which utilized the tides to turn their millstones. By the 18th century, these mills inspired a French engineer to devise a plan to produce energy continuously using the ebb and flow of the tides. For these tides are formidable, rising and falling over 44 feet. But it was not until 1960 that work on a Tidal Power Dam was undertaken. 1962, 1963, by 1964, the power plant was under construction. This would eventually house 24 turbo generators, in which the turbines and alternators together make up what is called a bulb unit, which uses both the ebb and flow of the tide to generate energy. Because of the need to make use of both high and low tide and the problem of storing energy when not in peak use, the Rance Dam had many features of interest to engineers throughout the world. By changing the direction of the vanes, as well as their angle, full advantage can be taken of the movement of the sea. It took 6 years to build this plant, first of its kind in the world. Years of experimenting had to precede construction. Materials had to be extensively tested. But by 1965, the dam had taken shape and much of the equipment had been installed. When the plant is fully operational, the huge turbines will generate 240,000 kilowatts of electricity. By March 1966, the water was let in. Today, the dam is completed, and the occasion was appropriately elaborate. President de Gaulle came from Paris to cut the traditional ribbon and make a speech in which he praised the dam as a great technological achievement. Five of the bulb units are already in operation. At the control room, the president switched the power from the dam to the national network. So the dam on the River Rance is judged a success.